pay attention, open up your books on the chapter Tree Tea from Assam, the third part of Glimpses of India. Right? So, first of all, what we have read about Baker from Goa, then we have read about Kurg. Both these two, you can say descriptions, they were completely filled of facts. So many things to remember. And definitely, you will get questions from that if it will be in the subjective form. Because board has not made it yet clear whether the next one will be subjective or objective. So you have to prepare in the subjective form also. But what I feel is, if you are preparing it in the subjective form, objective is automatically get prepared. Right? Because if you are going deep into the details, then automatically you are able to answer. Okay, but some wherever tricky questions are there, for that you have to do some kind of practice, right? So for that, the third one is tea from Assam. You know that Assam is famous for its tea estates. Okay, now here in this chapter, Pranjal, he has gone along with his friend to a tea estate, which is actually where actually his residence is. Okay, so while going there, what kind of observation he has made, and through his observation, the writer is going to describe us completely that what is going on there, okay? And what kind of atmosphere, what kind of life people live in Assam, okay? So let us start without giving much description. Let us start. And now who is this? Who's speaking? You people are taking advantage of mass. Pranjal, a youngster from Assam, is Rajveer's classmate at school in Delhi. So there are two main characters in this part. Who are these? These are Pranjal, who is from Assam, and Rajveer was his classmate. So which are the two main characters here? Pranjal and Rajveer. Pranjal is actually inhabitant of Assam. You don't have your book? Then keep the book in the center. Pranjal's father is a manager of a tea garden in Upper Assam, and Pranjal has invited Rajveer to visit his home during summer vacation. So this is a common practice among friends, like they are inviting each other to each other's houses. Okay, you are also enjoying the company and you feel very much delighted and happy when you go to your friend's house. The kind of attention, the kind of respect you get over there is always memorable for you, right? And sometimes these relationships of friendship, they are so deepened that they are carried forward throughout the entire life. Okay. So the thing is that, so Pranjal's father, who was a manager in one of the tea garden in Upper Assam, so Pranjal has invited his friend Rajveer during the summer vacation to come to his house in Assam. So let us see what he has, how he has visited there and what he has observed during his visit. Chai, garam chai, a vendor called out in a high-pitched voice. He came up to their window and asked, chai, saab. So while they were sitting in the train, there was a vendor who has come with small cups of tea, selling garam chai, hot tea. And he also asked them whether they want any cup of tea or not. Give us two cups, Pranjal said. Pranjal said, yes, give us two cups of tea. They sipped the steaming hot liquid. Almost everyone in their compartment was drinking tea too. So you know that tea is an integral part of our daily routine. Without tea, we feel dizzy also. We feel, you can say, lethargic also. Lethargic means lazy. Okay, so how many of you take tea? Do you take tea often? Okay, those who are taking, you always feel a chai nahi peeni chahiye. Right, same is with us. Okay, like it means in habit. Some people are saying that it is a sort of, you can say, habit developer. Yes, of course it is. When you don't take, you don't feel energetic. Okay, and ultimately it happens that it has turned out to be a great part of our life, that it is a main beverage which is served when any guest comes to our house. Without serving the tea, that hospitality seems to be incomplete. Right? Because whenever the guest arrives, the first thing one used to do is to serve a tea after serving water. Okay? So it means that it is served with snacks, it is served with cookies and all that. And ultimately, it's of course making a great combination. And who has given this beverage to India? Yes, Britishers. Britishers, they have given it to India. Okay, before that, see. Before that, no one is drinking tea. So we can imagine that how people, they were surviving. They were drinking then healthy drinks. They were drinking buttermilk. They were drinking only milk. And maybe to their guests also, they must be serving only milk. But when it has entered, there is mixture of water. Okay. In eating habits also, and there is mixture of water in relations also. Okay. Then after that, I think everything deterioration started taking place. Yes. Actually, it is of Chinese origin. I'm talking about India. Okay, India mein toh Britishers hi leke aaye the. Okay, they have started it. So, like Britishers, although they ruled over India, but they have given some positive effects also. Their presence in India has also given positive effects to India. It has given some good things to India. The education system that is prevalent, it is of course a gift of Britishers only. Whatever education policies they have set up, only now in the recent few years, there are some amendments, but otherwise what is going on, the complete curriculum is based upon that. Huh? No, education system to be brought to India is not a negative. This is where we lack. This is not their fault. It is our fault that we are not able to understand. We are not able to make changes. Okay, then it's our fault. We need to renovate it. We need to amend it as soon as the need arises. But we people are not doing it. The thing is that to lead a thing is very difficult. Many people, if in society also, you feel number of people are there who are giving suggestions. Aisa nahi aisa hona chahiye. Aisa nahi aisa hona chahiye. This is wrong. This system is wrong. But see, out of those who are giving suggestions, how many are coming forward to make the changes? No one. Because no one is bothering to take that much of, you can say, tension and stress. Because to lead a thing, it needs your dedication, it needs your leadership skills. And not all have. And see, in a class, suppose, it is very difficult to make all you 40 students agree on one point. Everyone has its own opinion. If I ask, beta, when I should conduct the test, you people will say, some will say, ma'am, kal hi le lo. Some will say, ma'am, Monday le lo. Okay, and when Monday will come, you people will say, ma'am, no, aaj nahi, fir uske baad le lena. It means that you people, if 40 people are not agreeing to a point, how all the countrymen can? How can all? It's not so possible. Okay, so it's very difficult to make someone agree on a point, on a single point. And those persons who are able to do this, who lead, this is the reason why they are called as leaders. And it's really a very difficult task. So coming back to the chapter. So they were sipping this liquid, hot liquid, which is called as tea. Almost everyone in their compartment was drinking tea too. So everyone in the compartment was drinking tea. It means that it is the habit of everyone to drink tea. People can't live without tea. People, it is in the eating habit. Okay. It is one of the main ingredient of their diet, which has now taken place. Do you know that 180 crore cups of tea are drunk every day? Very good. Throughout the world. Underline it. Okay. Over 80 crore cups of tea are drunk every day. Okay. And Rajveer said, so Rajveer has delivered this information to Pranjal that almost over 80 crore cups of tea is drunk every day. Whew, exclaimed Pranjal, surprising expression. Tea really is very popular. He said, oh, is that so? That tea is really very popular? The train pulled out of the station. Pranjal buried his nose in his detective book again. Pulled out of the station means it came out of the station. It started moving. Okay, so then again, you know, common habit during while you travel through train is to read a book in order to pass time. So he again buried his nose in his detective book again means with interest. With great interest, he was reading that detective book. And from here also, we come to know that he was habitual of reading detective books, or to read detective series was his favorite pastime. Rajvi too was an ardent fan of detective stories. Ardent means strong, fond of, right? Okay, he was also fond of these detective stories. But at the moment, he was keener on looking at the beautiful journey. So because the area, it's not new to Pranjal. So he has bored his nose into that book and he was reading that book. But for Rajveer, all the sights, they were fascinating him. Okay, he has never been to that place and he has never seen those books. Okay, so it is because of this reason that he was looking at all the scenes excitedly, in an exciting manner, with great, you can say, inquisitive look, curious look. It was green, green everywhere. All the areas, all the landscape is covered with green color. Why? It is covered with tea gardens and grass everywhere. Rajveer had never seen so much greenery before. Then the soft green paddy fields gave way to tea bushes. So earlier, what he has seen through the tree, through the train, window of the train, that paddy fields, okay, they were rice, yes, they were covering the entire area. But soon, with the transformation from one state to another, from one area to another, then there in place of paddy fields, there started the appearance of tea gardens and tea bushes. It was a magnificent view, very splendid, very attractive view it was. Against the backdrop of densely wooded hills, a sea of tea bushes stretched as far as the eye could see. So finally, then wooded hills come, where on the hills some trees were there. And after that, whatever is there, if one can see till that point where one's eye could reach, he can see there were completely, you can say, completely coverage of tea bushes in the entire area. And it was covered with greenery. Now, dwarfing the tiny tea plants were tall, sturdy shade trees, and amidst the orderly row of bushes, busily moved doll-like figures. See here, dwarfing the tiny tea plants means tea plants, because they are at very far place. This is the reason they seem to be dwarfed, smaller in size. Okay, and there stand sturdy shade trees, and the shade trees which are greater in height, they are giving out the shade. They make these tea bushes look very small. And among them, there was orderly row of bushes, busily moved doll-like figures. Among them, there was also organized row of what? Row of bushes, okay? Which have been just looking like dolls. And they have been very, you can say, clearly arranged. In the distance was an ugly building with smoke billowing out of tall chimney. So in the distance, what is there? There's a building, okay, ugly building, not so properly maintained, and smoke was rising above through the tall chimneys. Hey, a tea garden, Rajveer cried excitedly. So Rajveer was excited to see. He said, this is a tea garden. Pranjal, who had been born and brought up on a plantation, didn't share Rajveer's excitement. Yes, Pranjal did not show any kind of excitement because this was his native place. He has been brought about there. He has lived there. He has been grown up there only. Oh, this is tea country now, he said. Assam has the largest concentration of plantations in the world. You will see enough gardens to last you a lifetime. He said, yes, this is a tea country now. Tea country means it's a complete state. It is meant for tea plantations. So this is the reason why he said that this is, you can say, this is tea country now. And all the areas, they are covered with tea plantations. And what he said, now there are enough gardens that one can survive over them for a lifetime. I have been reading as much as I could about tea, Rajveer said. No one really knows who discovered tea, but there are many legends. So now they are coming to the exact point. He said, I have read in number of books that there are many legends which are associated to the origin of tea, but from where it exactly comes is not clear. Well, what legends? Pranjal said, what legends? Well, there's that one about Chinese emperor who always boiled water before drinking it. One day, a few leaves of the twigs burning under the pot fell into the water, giving it a delicious flavor, and it is said that they were tea leaves. So what he has said that one at one time, one legend, he has explained that a Chinese who was in habit of boiling water for drinking. So one day while he was boiling the water, the twigs, the okay, with which he has kindled the fire. Okay, those one of the, you can say one of the leaves or few leaves, they have fallen into the water pot which has been kept over those twigs to be boiled. And at that time, what has happened? He has not been able, or he may not have noticed that the leaves have been fallen into. Raghav, move your desk a little bit back, please. Now, fine. So now when he has drunk it, he has come to know that it is providing a delicious flavor to the boiling water. And some people said that those were actually tea leaves. Now, tell me another. Pranjal was excited to come to know, although he has lived or he has been brought about in those tea estates, but he did not know about the origin of tea. He said, what is the other legend? We have an Indian legend too. Bodhi Dharma, an ancient Buddhist ascetic. Ascetic means the person who is living a saintly life. Okay, devoid of all pleasures of life. Yes. Silence. Maintain silence. Now after that, he said that one of the Buddhist ascetic, whose name was Bodhi Dharma, he cut off his eyelids because he felt sleepy during meditation. See his dedication. He cut off his eyelids because while meditating, he feels sleepy. So 10 tea plants grew out of the eyelids. 10 tea plants, because in meditation, you know, according to the legends, I don't know whether it is true or not, that people used to meditate or enchant the name of God for years. Sometimes these Rishi Munis, they used to sit for long, long period of time, and then ultimately they are buried under mountains, buried under, you can say, heaps of earth and all that. Many legends are there. You must have read in about many of the religious books also, right? So what happened, because he was meditating and not being disturbed, what happened? Tea leaves, okay? Tea plants, 10 tea plants, they grew out of his eyelids. The leaves of these plants, when put in hot water and drunk, banished sleep. So when these, you can say, leaves of that plant, they have been put into water, then what happened? They did not help to induce sleep, okay? They banish one sleep. So tea was first drunk in China. So where tea was first drunk, underline it. It was first drunk in China. Rajveer asks, as far as back as 2700 BC. So when was the time when it was firstly taken, consumed? It was in 2700 BC. Okay. In fact, words such as tea, chai, chini are all from Chinese origin. Means all these words, they are related to Chinese. Tea came to Europe only in the 16th century and was drunk more as medicine than as beverage. Okay, and in the Europe, when it has come in 16th century, where it was not taken as a beverage, as a daily drink, but it is taken as a medicine. So, the train clattered into the Mariani Junction. The boys collected their luggage and pushed their way to the crowded platform. Now they have arrived to their destination, where they have collected their luggage and came out of the station in order to head towards their house. Pranjal's parents were waiting for them. They have come in order to receive them. Soon they were driving towards Dhekiabari. Okay, this is the name of the place. The tea garden which is managed by Pranjal's father. So what is the name of the tea garden which is managed? Okay, which is managed by Pranjal's father is Dhekiabari. An hour later, the car veered sharply off the main road. Okay, after an hour covering, you can say, encircled, you can say, destinations. Finally, they have came out to the straight road. They crossed a cattle bridge and entered Dhekiabari tea estate. Finally, after crossing a cattle bridge, they have come to this actual place. And on both sides of the gravel road, what is there were acre upon acre of tea bushes. So then what, when they have come to this actual place, yes, Raghav, silence. Okay. Gravel and sand, different type of, you can say, stones. Okay. So then ultimately where they have come to tea bushes, which is covering the entire stage and all neatly pruned to the same height. Prune means cutting off the trees to manage them. All have been pruned to an equal level. Groups of tea pluckers with bamboo baskets on their backs, wearing plastic aprons, were plucking the newly sprouted leaves. So this is the scene how the people, especially the women, they were wearing plastic aprons and moreover, they were hanging the basket with the belt upon their heads and they were plucking tea leaves. Pranjal's father slowed down to allow a tractor pulling a trailer load of tea leaves to pass. Then from them means then ultimately distribution also takes place. A tractor passed by and it has transferred all these things to that place. This is the second flush of sprouting period. Isn't it, Mr. Barua? Rajveer asked. It lasts from May to July and yields the best tea. So which is the best tea yield during which time of the year? It is from May to July. And the tea leaves plucked during that period, they give the best of tea leaves. So, you seem to have done your homework before coming, Pranjal's father said in surprise. Pranjal's father asked Rajveer, yes, before coming here, you have collected enough information about tea. Okay, because he knew many facts about tea. Yes, Mr. Barua. But I hope to learn much more while I am here. But he said, of course, but I will learn a lot when I am going to be here. That's it for the... Scoff means immediate reaction. Now let us see the back exercise, please. It is a heavy dash has been forecast due to low pressure in the Bay of Bengal. The options are given. What it can be? Upkeep, downpour, undergo. What it can be? It is downpour. Right. Next, Rakesh will dash major surgery tomorrow morning. No, undergo. Undergo. Rajesh will undergo a special. Undergo. Next. My brother is responsible for the dash of our family property. Upkeep, taking care. Upkeep, right. Okay. Next, the dash rate for this account. Which one? Walk-in drop rate. No, the dropout rate. Downpour, then undergo, then upkeep, then drop out. She went to enterprise company to attend a dash interview. Walk-in interview. Interviews are walk-in. What is walk-in interview? When it means that you register yourself at that very moment. Next, afterwards, second part. It is walk-in interview. In many advertisements, you must have seen. Then it is mentioned walk-in interview. Don't share the book. But then you turn your face towards me. She will not know. I told she will not know. Next, afterwards, second part. Fourth one, dropout. Next. Now fill in the blanks in the sentence given below by combining the verb given up in brackets with one word from the box. Okay, the army attempted unsuccessfully to overthrow. We have to pick up the preposition, overthrow the government. Scientists are on the brink of a major outbreak. Outbreak means onset. The state government plans to build a dash for bypass. Thank God, right. Gautam's dash on life changed. What changed? Very good. Outlook. Gautam's outlook changed. Rakesh seemed unusually downcast. Downcast means feeling very low. Okay. Next, afterwards, we will do afterwards, and questions are left. And that we will do in the next lecture, as only few minutes, 2 to 3 minutes are left. Okay. So that's all for today. And in the next class, we will do the question answers.